everybody. Reed here. Welcome to a Legacy gameplay video here on channelfireball.com. We are continuing our Blast from the Past series, and today I have Grixis Control, modeled after the deck that I played at Grand Prix Richmond in 2018, where we had a special coverage arrangement where I was in the feature match area every round. So if you haven't checked out that coverage and you're a fan of Legacy, I always get good feedback on that. People say it was really memorable for them and they enjoyed it. I won't spoil the ending for you. But anyway, this deck is a crowd favorite. A lot of people frequently ask me to revisit it. And it is pretty similar to what it was in the old days, with the single biggest difference being that I'm trying out a Yorion companion. I just think it fits well with like the games going long and having Baleful Strix. And plus you get to play a lot more sweet like one ofs when you have 80 cards to play around with. I also think Shouldred's Edict is like a really, really, really nice addition to the deck. I used to play a mix of Diabolic Edict and Dreadbore, but neither one was really perfect. But now Shouldred's Edict can take out an indestructible creature, a Merit Lage, or a Planeswalker like Minsk and Boo, or whatever it might be. So there's some cool stuff going on. I'm going to play this through a 4-round preliminary event, and we're going to see how it goes. Before I do get to that, you can read more about Legacy and any format that you enjoy with a CFB Pro subscription. This is all part of the larger TCG player subscription, which is only $7 a month. Thanks also to Ultimate Guard for helping to make this possible with their longtime support. And thank you for watching and for listening. Let's get to some games. Look, this sucker's only got 60 cards in their deck. I already feel like I'm an advantage. I have an advantage. Okay, this hand is potentially okay. It depends how fast my opponent's draw is going to be. I mean, realistically, I'm keeping anything with a land and a Brainstorm, but I do not have Force of Will or a quick removal spell for a creature. I guess I'm going to play Scalding Tarn and pass. Going to Evoke Grief, pitching Animate Dead. See how they stack the triggers. They want to look at my hand first. Well, I expect that their plan is to use a Reanimate or an Animate Dead on the Grief. So that would mean that they're definitely going to take Cling to Dust. The only thing I can really do in response is Brainstorm, but I think if they're gonna take the Cling to Dust anyway, then I should wait on the Brainstorm, because then they have less information to work with and I have more information to work with. So as expected, they take the cling to dust. Collective brutality to look for an instant or sorcery. So I'll brainstorm in response to that. Maybe have the opportunity to hide this drown in the lock. All right, so that's going to whiff. To cast Drown in the Lock. And then, I mean, the Narset or the Liliana, both uncontested, looks really good here. I think I'll choose the Narset. It's actually possible I should have just not used the Narset there. And, you know, like if I expect the Narset is not going to die, if they're not going to have like a Shouldred's Edict or a direct removal spell, then you can sort of like think about it as putting the activation in the bank, which might be useful against a deck that clearly has so much hand disruption. More planeswalkers. Don't mind if I do. So, I mean, they have clearly not had days at any point earlier in the game, so I think it's right for me to just slam. Uh-oh. Well, that would be a good way to get back in the game, except I do have Narset. So, in theory, if I can just... Okay. It's interesting. Oh, no! They paid the 7 life before attacking the Narset. You gotta attack the Narset first. So I have to admit that I think I played this game very suboptimally, in part because I had a misunderstanding of the matchup. I sort of had it in my head that my opponent was playing like a more fair style of game, where maybe they had like a Death Shadow, Street Wraith, Grief, Reanimation type of package. But now that I kind of think in retrospect, it should have been obvious to me that they were playing a combo deck. I was just thrown off by like, oh, Reanimator is usually red black and Death Shadow is usually blue black. So like this turn, I just slammed the Sorin, which is not an unreasonable play, but I also could have passed with Cling to Dust available. And of course, given what happened, that would have worked out better. So as bad as this is, I may need to just get attacked by the Archon so that I can hold up Cling to Dust. And then try to like end of turn Snapcaster, Drown in the Lock. The problem is if I Drown in the Lock right away, they just use Exhum again. Well, I guess Exhum, there's no beating Exhum anyway for me because they have multiple creatures in the graveyard. I guess I can just counter it. Yeah, there's no way I'm surviving this turn. You're going to cast Shouldred the Apocalypse. I suppose I'm okay with this. So beginning of combat, I kill the Archon. I don't see anything I can really do here besides pass with the Cling to Dust. If I, like, attack and the Snapcaster dies, then I Liliana minus to get it back. Is that something that can be good for me? It is possible that I want the Snapcaster in my graveyard for Exhum. but I don't know. I'll just pass and see what happens. Animate dead targeting Archon, so I will cast Cling to Dust in response. It's an interesting deck for sure. It's like an Esper Reanimator. I guess I still have not seen any non-black cards besides Atraxa. All right, I think I'm satisfied with the... Oh, man, if only I had a Lightning Bolt, right? Then I could... They draw seven and I could respond to the Shouldru triggers. All right. Oh, my deck actually didn't save correctly. I added a 28th land at the last minute and exited and re-entered the event, but it just gave me my old version of the deck anyway. But anyway, in the description of the video, I'll have a version with a 28th land, which is more what I would recommend if you want to copy this deck. So you can check that out. Anyway, Flusterstorm and four Surgical Extractions are coming right in. Probably that's it. I mean, Null Rod against Lotus Petal, but that's pretty thin. So these cards are all pretty good, and then marginal options. My opponent is mulligan to five. So hopefully with the Flusterstorm and the decent hand, and now, you know, I won't brain fart about what kind of matchup I'm playing. Hopefully I can perform better. So if they start on a discard spell, I'll probably choose to brainstorm and hide the fluster, something like that. But if they do nothing, then I'll do nothing also. You're going to cast a Dothi Voidwalker. Yeah, I guess I'm going to let that go and just Lightning Bolt it. And then I'm going to Brainstorm, which normally I wouldn't end of turn Brainstorm, but if I hit a third land, then I can pass with, you know, Snapcaster Brainstorm available, which is kind of desirable. So now I'm going to pass, and the thing I like about this position is, let's say my opponent's trying to set up a turn where they go Grief plus combo off, so the Grief to clear the way through my counter spells. When they look at this hand, there's actually nothing they can do with Grief, because if they take the Flusterstorm, I can Snapcaster it, and if they don't take the Flusterstorm, then I stop their combo. You're going to reanimate your Dothi Voidwalker. I'll fetch in response so that I can Shouldred's Edict it, but for the most part, I'm A-okay with that. Sacrifice a non-token creature. Oh, I missed with Narset. Yeah, I guess. Well, I can't Flusterstorm and animate dead. So if they have exactly animate dead, then it's bad for me. I guess there's no reason for me to risk that being the case. I don't like it because they can still just reanimate their Dothi Voidwalker, but at least that's a game where I'm still in it. As compared to if they go for the exact combination of Entomb for Archon and Animate Dead the Archon, then I'm probably in trouble. Man. And why Reanimator is tough is it's just a guessing game of like, well, I countered the Entomb, but they had two Entombs and only one, and their reanimation spell was Shallow Grave, so I just guessed wrong in that case. I mean, game one I played poorly. I should have passed with the Cling to Dust available on turn four. This game, I feel okay about my choices each step of the way, but just, you know, of course, if I somehow had knowledge of their hand, like if I had a discard spell or a peek or something like that, then I would know to save the Flusterstorm for Shallow Grave, and I would win. they're using Collective Brutality to drain me for two and clear the way. They could choose to use to activate Grizzlebrand again now that they're at 11. I can almost win if I draw a lightning bolt. Yeah, I don't think there's any combination where this goes well for me. Like the Shouldered Edict, of course, doesn't deal with the Archon because it's insulated right now. Can Snapcaster Brainstorm, but I don't think I'll have enough resources to do anything. Yeah, so even in the world where I can successfully block the Archon, I know my next card is a land, so. Even in the world where they never cast a spell for the rest of the game, I can't win this one. All right, not starting off on a good note here, but I'll be back. Hello friends, I've returned after what seems like a long time to me because I actually got a bye for round two. So the good news is I'm now 1-1 in the event. The bad news is that this video will only have 3 recorded matches, but that means 2 more to go and let's make them count. Be on the play with the Yorion Companion, and let's get to it. Alright, so I have Tropical Island Ponder, a pretty reasonable hand I think I'll keep. naturally there are ways for a hand like this to go badly if I, you know, brick on the ponder and then get wastelanded or something like that. Once upon a time, you got it. Finds wooded foothills. Okay. So I'm going to go for an Inquisition and a Bolt the Bird. The goblin in this particular case. Elvish Spirit Guide, Veil of Summer? In game one? What the heck? That is not what I expected to happen. Whatever I'm up against, it is not familiar to me. It must be some kind of brew. Could be like a Naya Depths deck. So if it has Dryad Arbor, it almost definitely has Green Sun Zenith. Could be like Abzan Maverick. Could be an initiative deck. Natural Order, I suppose that makes sense too. Well, I have just the answer for that. Let's hope that there's no further Veils of Summer. Personally, I like my natural orders to find Atraxa more than Progenitus right now. Zenith for three. Yep, you got it. Endurance me. Okay, it's pretty effective against both the Snapcaster and the Murktide. I got a Seasoned Dungeoneer and an Ancient Tomb. Block that. So I guess the reason to maybe not block is because now my opponent can take the initiative and get back into the game. But dodged a bullet there, so good news. Okay, why don't I start with Ponder? And I like everything about that. So I'm certainly going to draw a land. And then the question is, do I want to minus the Lily to pick up Baleful Strix? Honestly, I think I can just draw these cards and continue plussing. I guess I can just let Liliana get hit. Zenith for two, it's a Scavenging Ooze. I'm going to Fatal Push that. Then if my opponent taps Ancient Tomb, well, they're going to go up to 9 here. Oh, Veil of Summer, interesting. Well, now I guess I'm going to have to bolt the ooze. Yeah, that's fine. I wanted to just try to kill my opponent outright with like Bolt, Snapcaster Bolt, and a sneaky attack, but the ooze is way too dangerous. Man, multiple Veils of Summer. So let's say for sake of argument, I go Snapcaster, Bolt your Endurance. That will make the Murktide a 5/5. Then I plus on the Endurance to kill it. I take the initiative. I think I'm gonna cast Baleful Strix first because there's not much reason to do anything different than that. Now, sure, I mean, okay, I guess that play is still good because taking the initiative away from my opponent is a positive thing. I could just wait and win over the course of two turns with the bolts, but assuming the Murktide's going to connect in combat, this is better anyway. And then if I had sequenced differently and taken the initiative first to get my land and then tapped the swamp and then had a red open, I could win this turn. But remember, I didn't know I was going to draw the other Lightning Bolt off the Baleful Strix, so I didn't do it that way. And I have no basic mounted in my deck. But that was good. This feels like it could be an okay matchup, although the Veil of Summers are super scary. I think Plague Engineer is definitely a great card for me. And then I'm not sure what I want to do with like all the discard and permission. I mean, I guess I just don't have other cards to bring in. This Flusterstorm's okay because I can just counter a Veil of Summer. And then my weakest cards, like should I be taking out these Planeswalkers or... Yeah, I guess it would be a Planeswalker or a discard spell, maybe a Cling to Dust. This is like a not great hand, but with a Lightning Bolt, which of course is going to be good against a deck with all these mana dorks. I think I'm going to keep it. It's functional at least. Leyline of the Void. All right, that's good against my hand, though my opponent Mulligan started with a Leyline, so they really only have five cards to work with. And these Snapcaster Mages may get to work as Ambush Vipers. Blue, black, red, black. I have a 2/1. And I have another 2/1. I'm going to go for a Fatal Push, and then if they Veil of Summer it, which seems likely, I will Flusterstorm the Veil. The reason being, like, my opponent's playing an Ancient Tomb deck. I've got this little mini beatdown plan, and the Lightning Bolts, I think, are just, they're just going to go face. It's funny how a deck like Grixis Control can make use of Lightning Bolts targeting the opponent. Like, you think of this deck being, you know, a controlling deck. I want to win with Planeswalkers, play a long game. But sometimes your opponent just takes a little too much damage, and you've got this Bolt, Snapcaster, Bolt plan, and they're just dead. Okay, well, I'm not going to cast very many spells for the rest of the game, but I think I have what I need. They had to use a Spirit Guide for that choke, so my opponent's very low on resources, too. So we have a Hierarch and a Zenith for zero. I'm going to go Bolt U. So if I bolt the Arbor and attack, my opponent goes to two, then say the natural order for Atraxa could be bad for me. I think it's probably right to bolt the Arbor though. The question is kind of like, would I rather trade off a Snapcaster and then have the bolt still in my hand? Do I want to bolt the Hierarch? I mean, it, like, as I said, I'm not casting too many more spells this game, so I think I really want to win with what I have on the battlefield. But letting the Hierarch survive is scary for the natural order purposes. Casting Elvish Spirit Guide, sure. That is not as scary as it could have been. All right, I'm on the board. So 1-1 in matches played, 2-1 total record in the event, and I'll see you for the fourth and final match. All right, friends, welcome back to the third/fourth but final match of today's Legacy video. I would love to win this one and end things on a positive note. Mox Diamond. It's probably a lands deck. Whew, Sylvan Library is really good against me. But yeah, I mean, I guess it is what it is. Can eventually stop it with Narset. Playing out my fetch land so I don't get wastelanded. So that's Forest Exploration. How worried am I about Wasteland at this point? I'm going to brainstorm in response. With an island. I did find Force of Will. So I'm thinking I force pitching Snapcaster and then I try to just slam the Narset next turn. If I had brainstormed in my main phase, I would have found one of those discard spells. So I think I'm going to get Badlands. Narset. That stops the Sylvan. Okay, that's a cool play. Crop rotation for Urza's Saga. So here I think the move is ponder and then take the best card, and then I can clear the top of my library if I need to with the Narset's minus. So I would love to draw that Volcanic Island and then minus. So Cling to Dust like could be very good in this matchup, but my opponent has not found Life from the Loam yet. So I'm just wondering what I should do here. You know what I actually could do is just not minus. No, I want to because I want to hit more lands. All right, so why don't I take Fatal Push? Then I can go like bolt your construct, Fatal Push your other construct, and then untap and have a chance to slam the Murktide. Could also just slam the Murktide now as a 6/6. It's pretty good. I could really see a case for taking any of these cards, but I'm going to take the Fatal Push, and then I'm going to play a big Murktide Regent. Shadow Spear, okay. Well, I guess I can't attack now because the Shadow Spear will just put my opponent back in the driver's seat. If I find a swamp, then I can Fatal Push, which would pump the other one down to a 3/3, and then I can bolt and be in great shape. We're just not at that point yet. Hoping my opponent can't find Life from the Loam. Okay, that exploration is fine. So not equipping the Shadow Spear, it does make me worry about crop rotation. So is there any way I stay in this game? Like, block with Murktide, then I draw Brainstorm into Swamp, Baleful Strix, then I get to the Jace somehow. If they're going to equip the Shadow Spear, it gets even worse for me. All right, fair enough. One thing about this Grixis deck is it is vulnerable to Wasteland. I also mentioned at the start of the video, I should have 28 lands. I've played with 27 a bit, and it's not enough. So if you try this deck, just add a 28th land. I'm going to bring in Hydro Blast as a hedge against, well, I guess they're likely, they could have any combination of Gamble, Punishing Fire, and maybe Minsk and Boo after sideboard. And at worst, I can just always pitch those to Force of Will. So like, if I'm going to have a bad card, at least let's make it a bad blue card. All right, so I have a blue producing land, two cantrips, some discard spells, which are not great. This hand is functional, but it doesn't really have any of the cards that I'm looking for the matchup. So I think I'm gonna mulligan. This one at least has a surgical. So yeah, I'll just keep this and bottom the swamp. My opponent has also mulliganed, for what that's worth. Interesting. All right. Just gonna do nothing for now. I guess I do have to fetch before the Saga trigger goes off, because if they're to needle my Polluted Delta, that would be a disaster. So I'm just going to go for the old one of each dual land configuration. And then I could surgical the Urza Saga, but I don't really like to guess in that way. Let's wait until they play, like a Life from the Loam or something. Or they may choose to get Expedition Map. Mm-hmm. I think I'm just going to take the three, actually, and then Kolaghan's Command end step. I don't know. That's probably just taking 3 unnecessary damage, but I don't know. I'm not sure what to do there. So let's destroy this construct and deal 2 to the other one. Cast Baleful Strix. Okay, you have Mox Diamond. That's the first colored source. Yep, you have an exploration. Have at it. So in theory, I could Snapcaster, I could Surgical the Urza Saga, and then later Snapcaster Surgical the Life from the Loam, but that would just not work against the Soul Guide Lantern. But I now have 2 Surgicals. But I also have Meltdown. So what I could do is let the sagas do their thing for a little while, then just try to melt down all the tokens. So let's say, for the sake of argument, I shuffle away Surgical Extraction and Shouldred's Edict. And then grab the Yorion. Actually, Shouldred's Edict's pretty good, and the Snapcaster I can't reliably use against the Soul Guide. I could also shuffle away the Scalding Tarn, which that's probably the best move. Though I wouldn't mind just getting the Yorion onto the battlefield. Okay, let's shuffle away Surgical and Snapcaster. I'm going to let the Life from the Loam resolve. End step, I'm going to search for a Badlands and spend 1 mana to Surgical Life from the Loam. This move. Yep. Oh man, that's really bad that I walked into that. That's a classic way for the lands players to play around Surgical is to just have a instant speed card draw so they can dredge the card out of the graveyard, and I walked right into that. There's no sugarcoating it. Guess at least I drew Snapcaster Mage. Hmm. So here's Life from the Loam. Exploration. Wow, they have a choke in hand. That is very scary. So two chokes, two Sylvan Libraries, bunch of Pyroblasts came in. Other than that, no real surprises. The Saga targets are Mox Diamond, Shadow Spear, Pithing Needle, Expedition Map, and Soul Guide Lantern. So I just have to try to not walk into the choke too badly. Not sure if there's anything I can do about the choke. That's the problem. Oh, they drew crop rotation. So they rotate for another saga. I mean, I guess they're just going all in on the saga stuff, which is not that bad for me given that I have the meltdown. I imagine they go for expedition map. With chapter 3. So we melt down for one attack. They are going to maze the Yorion and go to 7. I have a lightning bolt in hand, so they probably can't really tap the ancient tomb anymore. But they're going to start right going with the constructs again. Constructs are just going to be 2/2s right now. So they should have an expedition map and a pithing needle left to get. Technically Mox Diamond, but that's ineffective right now. So you think this is the only lightning bolt I left in my deck, which is kind of funny. Could maybe find a blue source and a snapcaster. Dak Thedain, okay. Please sacrifice a creature token. And I just keep chipping away. The Yorion gets mazed, but then it can block. The Baleful Strix needs to connect 3 more times, and then the Lightning Bolt finishes the job. Oh, baby. Kolaghan's Command can do it, too. So let's go, you take 2, and I return Snapcaster Mage from my graveyard. Could have also chosen Destroy an Artifact. All right. So now the big surprise is the chokes. I actually didn't see anything for the blue blast. Well, I can blue blast a red blast, but that's pretty thin. The discard is not very good on the draw. So then it's like having more lightning bolts. Fatal push is only against constructs. Liliana could technically just come down and start plussing, and maybe win that way. I guess I'm going to keep the discard because I could strip away a choke and have that be meaningful. Him could actually be worse than Lightning Bolt and worse than Thoughtseize. All right, here we go. Last game of the event. Let's make it count. I played really poorly in that game too, but I was able to scrape over the finish line regardless. And I can work with this. A little bit awkward in that I would want my turn one play to be Inquisition, but unless I draw another land, I can't really do that for fear of Wasteland. Very strong. Very strong opening. Alright, so now having drawn that, I guess I could go Swamp Inquisition. They took 8 off the Sylvan Library, so there's now 5 cards in hand. Mox Diamond, Bojuka Bog, and the 3 that came off the top. Trying to save the Surgical Extraction until I have a little more information. You're going to play Sphere of Resistance. So what should I do? Surgical Extract the Dark Depths in response. Well, they did draw a Thespian Stage. So it's just 2 Mox Diamonds, Stage, Bog. Sideboarding. Oh, it's down to 2 blasts and up to the four spheres. Yep, fair enough. Force of Will shows up right on time. Oh, no, no, no. Oh, I should have fetched before the pithing needle can enter. Choose the needle anyway, but the Soul Guide Lantern makes me think they might have found life from the loam. No, I guess Taiga is the card that they drew there. Alright, so I'm just going to play Baleful Strix and hope I don't have to use Force of Will this turn. Block. I don't have to block, but I'm going to choose to. They found the choke. Now they found life from the loom. That's not going well. All right, I'm kind of a sitting duck here. I'm just gonna get. They're going to cast Life from the Loam again, and they're going to wasteland me out. Crop rotation. Okay, you have crop rotation.
Yes, I am.
There's no dark depths left, remember.
I encourage it. Wherever you can.
Rishadin Port. Makes sense, because that's so strong against in combination with the choke. So I don't want to play this because it's just going to get ported. So remember, I can't cast any of these spells against the Sphere of Resistance right now. So the only thing that makes sense to fetch is a Badlands there, because if I fetch any island land, they're just going to tap it and it'll be choked forever. They can wasteland the Badlands, but let's at least make them do that. With the second sphere, I think I'm locked out of the game. So yeah, these just get ported. I think I'm going to throw in the towel. I'm defeated. All right, so not a great showing with Grixis, but you know, still learning a lot about what's possible in Legacy. I hope you enjoyed the video. We have tons more content about Legacy, Modern, all other formats on Channel Fireball website. So I hope we'll see you there.